The mangoes that you see on your screen are cut into pieces. The mango is of an average size of the one that you have in your picture screen. Each of them is cut into 4 to 8 pieces. And this is done professionally. Don't try it at home. There are people who cut mangoes and give it to you, because the knife that you're required to use is a sharp, big one. We get it cut in the market after choosing the right raw mango, and then they are cut and dried. After the mangoes are cut into pieces, you will realize that even the seed of the mango is cut and is a part of each piece that you have. The next step is to remove the pieces of the seeds from the main content of the mango and ensure that the mango is without the seed and the thin layer that divides the mango piece and the seed. For 25 mangoes, the size of which you will see is this, which Ritika holds in her hand, we are using 1.5 kgs of ginger garlic paste, which is 750 grams each of ginger and garlic. 750 grams of ginger, 750 grams of garlic, both of them shelled and made into a minute paste. 1.5 kgs of salt, 3/4 kg of red chili powder, 50 grams of jeera powder, 50 grams of methi powder, and 2 teaspoons of haldi for 25 mangoes. You will see now that paste is already made and kept ready. If you're wondering why I'm using 1.5 kgs of salt as against 3/4 kg of red chili, the reason is that the paste of ginger garlic has its own amount of spice, which will balance the amount of salt that's going into the mixture. Now, 25 mangoes dipped in oil, which you will see next to the red tub. They go into the oil first. They're just touched with it and then now put into the mixture. Pour oil into the container. Smear it unilaterally across all sides inside the container. And then now start transferring the pickle into the said container. We now present how to make garlic avakai. Now, in contradistinction to ginger garlic avakai, this does not contain ginger, it contains only garlic. The requirements would be for 8 measures of cut mango. Now, you notice that she's carrying 1 measure. Obviously, the measure would have to be of even, the vessel would have to be of even space so that you know how much you're adding. To 8 measures of cut mango, you will add 1 measure of chili powder, 1 equal measure of salt, 1/2 measure of mustard powder. You see in the picture that it is not exactly 1 measure, and that is because Ritika has already taken the balance salt while grinding a part of the garlic. To this mixture, you will also add 25 grams of fenugreek powder and 50 grams of fenugreek seeds. Once again, dip the pieces of the cut mango in oil before you put it into the mixture. Half a measure of mustard powder. Into this, approximately 25 grams of fenugreek powder, menthulu podi, and 50 grams of fenugreek seeds. Into this, approximately 25 grams of fenugreek powder, menthulu podi, and 50 grams of fenugreek seeds. About 1.5 teaspoons of turmeric powder. Now add the paste of garlic of the 1/2 kg plus garlic that she's using, 200 grams of garlic paste, and in addition to the 200 grams of garlic paste, 1/2 kg of garlic in pod form. Peeled away from the main pods are the small ones of the garlic pearls added to the mixture. Approximately 1/2 liter of oil has gone into this mixture. Mix it well. Mix the mango pieces with the hitherto mixture completely and thoroughly. You would also notice that the finesse with which cooking has been done on this channel or on this platform is fairly different from what you see today. And the reason being, for this kind of quantity, you would require this kind of work to be done. Delicate work won't help in the making and preservation of pickles. Understand that this is being made for a year, not for a day. I know of my friends and relatives who keep Ritika's pickles not just for a year, but for multiple number of years, and for that, all these precautions need to be taken. Ensure that there's not a drop of water anywhere nearby and everything is without water. You notice once again oil is going into the jar. After pouring the oil, the sides are smeared with the oil. 1/2 liter of oil had already gone in. About another 1/4 had gone when the jar was smeared. Now the remaining another portion of about 1/4 liter of oil is going in. You will realize that even this would not be sufficient over a period in time. As you see the mixture now, the mango pieces and the other ingredients have gone into the jar. A little bit of oil above it. With this pickle too, on the third day, you will revisit it, check how much of oil has been absorbed by the pieces, and add oil, as I said, to the extent that there must be at least 1 inch of oil above the surface of the pickle.
Good morning. On day 3, all that we need to do is transfer it into this container again and mix it thoroughly. And after mixing it, you need to taste whether everything is fine, whether the salt is adequate, whether the chili powder is adequate, everything is adequate, and then transfer it again into the jadi. And at this point of time, you need to ensure that the oil content is definitely about an inch or two above the level of the pickle. I will now transfer it into the jadi. I have already tasted it and it is perfectly fine. This is the garlic pickle that I have made, and I have completely mixed it. And to preserve it for an year or more, you need to have that much of oil on top of it. You may not use that oil, but definitely for preserving you need that oil, otherwise the salt gets crystallized over a period of time. This is the same procedure that I would be doing for all the pickles that I have made.